Stream Deck is a cool little hardware device that allows you to control your computer at the click of a button. It has, depending on the model, sometimes 6, 15, or even more buttons that light up that can be controlled. And then when you click these buttons, they cause actions. This was originally done for streamers. So maybe you want to switch out of your game, put your face on the screen, then go picture in picture, then hide yourself, then pop something up on the screen. You don't want to stop your game, go and make those changes. Obviously, that's going to mess up the stream, but you probably even die in the game. Do you already have a Stream Deck? What do you use it for? I'm sure for a lot of people, the answer is, well, I use it for streaming games or other types of content creation. People have found really interesting uses for these devices. Teachers have used them to teach their online classes better. I've even used them for controlling Zoom meetings. Exciting, I know. But have you thought about using your Stream Deck for programming? There are so many things in modern editors and IDEs that you want to be able to do, and often it's an awareness problem. You don't even remember, oh, I could actually run this command and make something awesome happen. So in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to set up a scheme, a profile that allows us to work better as Python developers using our Stream Deck. So I've created a profile for PyCharm, and we're going to go through how to create it, what commands are in there, and how you can change it if you'd like your own special flavor of a programming Stream Deck. It's pretty awesome. I think you're going to love it once you get it set up. Now let's just start by seeing it in action. Here you can see we've got the Stream Deck, and it's got basically a back button to the other profiles. I have many different profiles, so all of mine have a way to go back. And this one is focused on PyCharm, so we've got open PyCharm. If PyCharm were closed, I would just click this button. It will come right back. Even if it's minimized, click it, and it just comes right back. Pretty awesome. If I want to run an application, I can press here. I can hit a hotkey, but I can also, if I'm over here fiddling around, press this button to just run the code, which is pretty fantastic. Sometimes you make mistakes and you want to debug them, so we can press the debug button instead, and then you can see down here we're running the debug stuff at the bottom. Pretty awesome. There's actually a bunch of little apps that I'm running. This is from one of my Python shorts. Now, running these apps below, I might want to run that one or that one, and you might even need to configure it. So over here, we've got all these run configurations, and you can click, go up here and click edit and configure it, or you can just go over here and click show me the run configurations. But, you know, maybe we don't need that one anymore. We'll remove it. Maybe this one we want to add, arg true, add some kind of argument to run it differently. We hit run again. Boom. Now it's running over here with that argument you can see on the right. Pretty awesome, huh? So you might want to edit your run configurations. You sometimes want to navigate around the windows, like go either hide or show, or just get back to the project window, depending what's open. Check out your code changes. If we had made a change here, we would see our stuff that we could commit. We could go make a change. If we had a pull request over on GitHub, we could press the PR here, which is awesome. Opens up this pull request section. We could do search. You can go over here, click on this, and then you can search for, you know, something like a method or whatever, right? We've got the word query appearing a few times as right here, for example. Or if we wanted to search, we could just press the search button right there and pull that up. It remembers what we did last. Let's just get the hotkeys, all kinds of stuff, like under the actions. We could look at run and see what those commands all are. Fantastic. What else have we got? This one is a really cool one, this column edit mode. Let's suppose down here in this section, I want to be able to make changes and type input colon and then this, input colon then this. I could go and just type input colon da da da. This is not the way you should be doing it. Check this out. So we can use column input mode. So if I highlight this and I press this button, I can now type input, boom, navigate around. Now we want dashes like this. Hit that button again and it toggles back. You can even see it displays, it's in column mode. If you click it again, it'll go to regular mode and so on. So it even shows a cool different icon there. Finally, we've got just show the terminal at the bottom. Now beware, the other keys, they all stop working in the terminal because all the instructions go to your shell. So you gotta not have focus there, but then we can open up the Python REPL, the packages, the debug or play run window there. And we can even click this to do get latest from source control. So you can see down here, it says all files up to date. I'll press it one more time. See, it's fetching from GitHub. There we go. All of this stuff is available in just a single button click, and it's right here in your Stream Deck to remind you. You can even set it up so that when you have focus on your editor, this comes up, and when you leave, it'll turn it back to your default profile, which is all pretty awesome, I think. Let's pull up our Stream Deck app here and configure the Stream Deck. So you can see we've got the PyCharm configuration or profile selected, and this is the big UI version of exactly what you saw here. Now, to set this up, all you have to do is go over here to your profiles, click here and say import, and then browse over to wherever we had the PyCharm stuff, wherever you got it from GitHub, and import this. Now, this won't work right away because PyCharm doesn't have enough hotkeys at the moment to allow us to control it in all the ways I just showed you. So you're going to have to do a tiny bit of configuration, which I'll show you here. So you should be able to import this. The one thing that might look a little wonky is this might have an error, in which case you have to browse to where your PyCharm application is. So this, if you have the installed via the toolbox up here, the way it gets installed does all sorts of stuff about where it's located. So often you've got to like reset that. I'm not really sure how to make any difference there, but you might have to configure that. The rest of these things should be set up, but they won't work for all of them, because the way this is set up is it sends hotkeys or keystrokes over to PyCharm, which is great, but some of the features I showed you literally don't have some sort of hotkey. So let me run you through that real quick. So this one, open, that's straightforward. Run, Control R, or whatever, if you've changed your hotkey mapping, you're gonna need to just change that here. You could just come over here and say, you know, whatever it is, I'm gonna say Control R, because that's what mine is. Debug, Control D, super similar. But for example, configs, there's by default no config. So let's go check this out. So if you go over here to your key map, we search for edit configuration, you can see it's got this sort of weird hotkey. By default, this is how it looks. There's just no keystroke that you can send to pull up that window. So what you'll need to do is just double click over here, add keyboard shortcut, and then come over here and see what keyboard shortcut I've used. I've used something I thought would definitely not conflict as many keystrokes as possible. So we're using this. So there's a couple you're gonna have to go and search under key map, search for them, double click here and set a keystroke for them. Otherwise, there's just no way for this little setup to pass that command over. All right, so edit configurations, you're gonna need to set a hotkey for that. Project, that has a built-in one. Commit, that has a built-in one. Oddly, pull requests, that pull request window has no hotkey. So again, go under there and find the tool window under the key map for pull requests, set this hotkey. Search, same, search everywhere is what you wanna go search for. This one has a built-in one, so that should work. Again, terminal works. REPL, this Python console here, has no hotkey, so you're gonna have to go and set the hotkey to this. Show Python packages, no hotkey there. Show the debug window and toggle between a debug and the run configuration, which is pretty cool. That's all set up, and this get latest from GitHub or source control, already set. So that's all you gotta do to make this work. Import the profile, make sure it locates your PyCharm if you want that there, and then add these various hotkeys that you have to add back into PyCharm under key map, and then you just search for them. Most of them are actually under a tool window. That's what we're looking for. That's it. Then you'll be all set up. The final thing is, if you would like, when you have focus on the application, for it to go here, you could say, let's make this the default profile here. And then this one is set to be PyCharm. Notice I've selected this application. So now, if we get this out of the way, move it over here, and we click away, and this is not up, I gotta close this. Click away, it goes to the home, but you can see right here. If I go back, it automatically pulls up the PyCharm profile, and then it goes back away. So only if I'm actually working in PyCharm does that come up. Honestly, I don't use this very much because I'm often doing presentations with PyCharm, but I need to control other software like the recording software, streaming software. But this might be really useful in just a pure software development mode, is to set this up as being tied to the PyCharm application, which is pretty awesome. So what do you think? Is this cool? Do you want it? If you do, then just go over to github.com Mike C. Kennedy Stream Deck Developer Profiles, and you'll find one for PyCharm. Right now we've got one for PyCharm and one for Jupyter that I'm also working on. I think Jupyter Notebooks and Jupyter Lab really deserve something like this as well. So look for a video on that. And you just go over here and download this file. You don't really need to download the icons, but they're there if you want to remix them and do fun stuff with them. So there it is. We can use our Stream Decks for programming as well. In this video, we did it with PyCharm, but you can do this for pretty much any editor that you can control with hotkeys. So use your creativity. Let us know what you come up with in the comments and share your ideas down there. And while you're there, please, please, please like this video. It really helps support our work. Check out the Talk Python to Me podcast and Talk Python training, where we have hundreds of hours of Python courses. Enjoy using that new Stream Deck for programming.